I just had a successful test of my backup power system for my modem. You may be aware that the phone company has a separate power system so that if the grid goes down, your modem connected to your phone line will continue to run for some period of time, at least until the phone company runs out of fuel or whatever. But anyway, for quite some time, I've kept some batteries here. These are AGM batteries, and I have about 80 amp hours worth of power here, and those are kept connected most of the time to a battery charger. And the rest of the system here is that I have this 100 watt inverter connected to the batteries using this set of plugs here, and this in turn powers the modem. And so what happened just now was the power was down for maybe 15-20 minutes, and I immediately went to hook up the inverter to the modem, and the modem did come back up, and I was able to use the internet on my tablet. And if you had a laptop with a separate power supply, that would probably run as well. This is kind of an important thing for emergency situations, that you should have some way to keep your modem running on backup power in case the power does go down. So the second point I want to make is that because we are having ongoing storms, I'm just going to leave this hooked up this way. I may do it for quite a while. But certainly if you're in a place where there are power outages and you have the ability to set up a system like this, I highly recommend it. I'd also like to add that running your base station, whatever you do for that, off a battery and a battery charger is a good idea to cover you in these situations where the grid goes down. If you're running off a power supply that depends on the grid, then when the grid goes down, your system goes down as well. One thing that has come out of the experience of these storms is that the repeater networks have continued to function throughout. Using these two radios, I've been able to monitor the All-Star network, the Carla network, and the Papa network. And there have been a few cases where mountaintop repeaters have been covered with too much snow to work very well, but by and large they have continued to function. My worst case scenario is that the power would stay down long enough so that the batteries would have to be recharged, and for that purpose I keep these heavy-duty jumper cables that I can attach to my car. Those AGM batteries take power pretty fast, and I found that you have to have heavy-duty cables to do that. So behind that, of course, you need to keep your car filled up so that you have that source. But cars have big generators in them, or alternators. They're like 80 to 120 amps. So it's quite a big source of power and a lot more convenient than keeping a separate generator.